Fire. This pandemic is not slowing down violence in the Duke City. Another homicide last night in Coronado Park. So that's 5 homicides in 48 hours, and this is the 3rd at that park just this year. Ryan Laughlin's been trying to ask Mayor Tim Keller if the city is going to change how they manage that park, but some say they're not optimistic change is coming.
Instead of straightening out the problem,
it's becoming increasingly dangerous.
Ralph DePlama has dedicated most of his life to trying to serve the homeless. Almost every night, the volunteer minister goes to Coronado Park.
There are many homicides
among the homeless unreported. Deliberate drug overdoses and missing persons.
Albuquerque police say this year they know of 3 homicides that have happened at Coronado Park. The most recent was last night. A man was killed possibly
with a shovel during a fight.
An Albuquerque Police Department spokesperson says APD was here, clearing out the park just before the homicide happened last night. They identified Randy Hillard as the victim. He's 49 years old, and DePlama says he knew him well.
So Albuquerque has become
a sanctuary city for the repeat offender, homeless man and woman.
DePlama says they've tried to engage with Mayor Tim Keller. They wrote him a letter with more than a dozen businesses' signatures asking for help.
10 months, no real answer. Just a makeshift
response.
You feel they're brushing you off.
To speak to Mayor Tim Keller, the elected official who is ultimately responsible for managing Coronado Park. His spokesperson told us he wasn't available today and provided us a statement instead that says, in part, that Coronado Park is and has been a problem and it won't be fixed until they get the Gateway Center up to get vulnerable people off the street. If you want to check out that full statement, it's up on KOB.com.